In order to determine the sequence of a polypeptide beyond the N-terminal sequence, one needs to perform a sequential degradation. And so here's a polypeptide showing the last three residues. In the sequential degradation known as the Edman degradation, the last group will be removed and analyzed first, then the second to last group will be removed and analyzed second, and then the third group will be removed and analyzed third. This is the process known as Edman degradation, and this webcast covers the chemistry that goes on in the Edman degradation process. It involves the reagent phenylisothiocyanate, whose structure is shown here, and phenylisothiocyanate is electrophilic at that carbon. So with the nucleophilic amino group, the first step involves nucleophilic attack of that amino group onto the electrophilic carbon of the phenylisothiocyanate to generate first this intermediate shown here. That sulfur group basically will do a rearrangement where there'll be an internal proton transfer, that is essentially a tautomerization kind of step, to make this thiocarbamate structure that's shown here, or it's sometimes called a thiourea. What we see now is the completion of the step one of this repetitive process. At this point, the reaction conditions would be changed to acidic conditions, often by the addition of HF. And what HF will do is first it will protonate that oxygen of the amide carbonyl. Once that oxygen is protonated, we have an internal nucleophile that will allow a five-membered ring to form. And so with the nitrogen lone pair basically doing a donation into the carbon sulfur pi bond, and that doing an addition into the carbonyl group that's been protonated, this five-membered ring can form. Now with general acid catalyzed assistance, this oxygen can do a beta elimination, eliminating the bond between the carbon and nitrogen group, and again there will be a general acid HF will use as our general acid to facilitate that beta elimination step. That generates this five-membered ring known as a thiazolene. It contains that one amino acid that was originally on the terminus of the chain, and then we're all set up to repeat the process again. We've got the second to last amino acid residue ready to be resubjected to the first step of the Edman degradation process, or Edman sequencing method.